Ja, die is er nou nog niet, nee.
Geen zo'n zorg.
Die is nog in de arke digest, vind ik. Ik heb een hele artier aan de. Ik heb er die koude groen aan de.
Ja,
landen.
Ja,
landen.
Ik denk කොහොමද වෙලා තියෙනවද අදින්නවද නේද එහෙම යනවද නේද නේද කොහොමද
නෑ පය සමාර කරනවා සමාර
හරි මම හිතන මගේ මොකක් විශේෂ දෙයක් අහන්න ආවේ අපි ලන්දන් අපි
යනවා
Mamy na to tam, a teraz na tym miejscu. Mamy na to, że mamy tam layout transgender. Mamy na to, że mamy tam layout
transgender. Yes, I was going to ask you.
When did I cut your hair?
I don't have to have another haircut for a long time.
Yeah, I hope so in Sansara.
I was going to ask you, did you finish your university degree?
No, I didn't.
Okay.
I didn't.
So
I didn't want to go, I had to go to university because my father, I didn't finish it, but my parents tell to others that have faced me. Because they have that idea of me, you know. And when I can face that in a way. After this experience I was telling last time, I was I didn't want to go to any when I went to university also, when the lectures were this sort of lecturing. There was one lecture I remember, and I could see like from far away, like it's no real authenticity. It was all like just knowledge.
Yeah.
Just knowledge coming out and just putting that into a picture and then presenting it. So anyway, I had to go, and then it spoiled that wisdom after some after 3 months, 4 months. I just lost that stillness, and still I'm regaining. I'm now doing another type of actually. And yeah. There, those days I had this deep kind of instant wisdom. So I'm not attached to wisdom mostly. So detachment is the highest wisdom. And I'm enjoying the practice. So I believe in sometimes the karma and things like that. So long period I was in another type of meditation, of samadhi and pursuing that. This is always there, especially at the moment of crisis. When I face nearly death and all that, it was there. I have to watch myself and not to identify. And daily I do a little bit of it also.
It's funny when you spoke also about St. Francis.
Yeah.
Because it brought back a lot of memories for me. Yeah. Because when I was very small, I went to school first at 5 years old.
Yeah.
The school I went to, there was a very big picture, as big as that mirror, of St. Francis with all the animals and the birds around him. So every day in class, you would look at the picture, and it related back to what you're talking about.
Yeah, you will get all the spiritual memories coming.
They come back, yes, very much so, yes.
I feel very much similar to me this present time. I feel I'm like something very similar to Francis, like.
Well, my name is Francis as well.
Okay, thank you. So normally these saints, they inspire me, especially his, you know, I was in one ashram when I was before monk, I think. Yeah, before I was a monk, I don't know, I went anyway, in India. Suddenly they were showing the story of Francis. I thought, okay, some Christian, you know, some saint, and not very interesting. If someone says me Saint Anthony, I'm not inclined to go. Some people think I like all the Christian saints. No, I like Saint Patrick's also. You know, Saint Patrick who took to Ireland, no?
Yes.
Very similar. I could just relate to my own life. And there, here I went to, just I went by chance and just I was seated there. And my goodness, I couldn't imagine the same spirit, you know. I can't tell you how I was in tears. I was, and then to see, I can see my life similar. Yes. Today, like kind of a revolution. Now, you know, like it's funny, like 2012, I came to public and it was just simply the attachments of monasteries, monks, which is happening in the current day. Yes. And the problems going through computers. I never imagined to speak like this. And my discourse and about sexuality, certain habits, you know, we don't know, and we're just like, we are hiding it away, and then just, and then all our spiritual thing is being killed like nothing. So these are the things. So I'm trying to create groundwork, a lot of my deep, also my own path. So it relates to.
Have you been to America?
No, maybe.
Oh, are you going to America?
I am going to, yeah.
Are you going to San Francisco?
No, Los Angeles, I just, New Jersey, like this.
Because San Francisco, there is a church that stands up on the wall, which is St. Francis, the church.
Yes.
Which stands and looks over San Francisco.
Okay.
So I just thought.
But I, you know what happened? I was in Italy, in Assisi. I was there, the very monastery where his body or the remnants, you know, the relics are kept. I went this trip.
Yes.
This, I also made a kind of because it was not possible to go one period, then suddenly it was arranged. It was a very special trip.
Good.
And I feel I need the strength of all the saints.
Yes.
To do this.
Yes.
And all the spiritual fathers, you know, and gather them. So it's a big war. Not an easy one.
Yeah.
It's a very big war against all the defilements. And even now when I'm coming now, I do a certain practices. So this is something which is, you know, connected with some strength and some energy. So it takes time. But on my own, the silencing is another practice. So I'm glad that you got some memories and inspiration.
Yes, you got memories back.
I'm happy.
Certain things trigger, don't they? They trigger the mind and the brain, and trigger back something that you think you've forgotten.
Right.
And it comes back again.
And definitely. You see, though I am dressed like this, I don't think this is my real dream, to sort of ignite and all the good noble qualities, not to have any labels into that. And then do the, what are the spiritual principles? And they are universal. And they are common, and if you get an experience of it, it's like some kind of food, you know. Biryani is biryani, I don't know. Or here some spaghetti, the taste of spaghetti. So the taste of peace, purity, and wisdom, they even go hand together, and it should be universal. මේ මහත්තයට තමයි ඇත්තේ කවුද අනුරාධ අනුරාධපුරේ අනුරාධ
සොමනස් අපි ඔද්දී ප්‍රශ්නයක් ඇහුවා ඒක මම හිතන්නේ උත්තරේ හැමදාටම හොඳ වෙයි අයි පාර්ක් එක පොඩ්ඩක් පැහැදිලි කරොත් මට තිබි ටික ප්‍රශ්න තමයි සොමනස් කොහොමද ඇහුවේ ඒ කියන්නේ අපි යම්කිසි මාර්ග ඵලයකට හරි යම්කිසි මාර්ගයට යොමු වෙනවා නම් අපි මුලින්ම බෞද්ධ කටිට අවසාන බලාපොරොත්තු නිර්මාණය නම් ඒකට ඇත්තටම පෙරපින් තිබිය යුතුද මම අහපු ප්‍රශ්න සමාන සුතව දුන්නා මට මන්ත්‍රණකට ප්‍රයෝජනවත් වෙයි කියන එක පෙරපින් තිබිය යුතුද අපිට මේ ආත්මෙදිම ඒක ළඟා කරගන්න පුළුවන් ද යම් කිසි දුරකට
අපි තියන්නේ පින් වැඩිමින් දෙක තියෙනවා මම කියන්නේ කිව්වේ අර ආයෝ මෙයා කන්දකම ඒකස් පාට මාප් එකක් තිබ්බ පින් වැඩිමින් දෙක තියෙනවා එකම අපිට අවශ්‍ය කරන ප්‍රැක්ටිස් එක මතු කරලා ගන්න. විශේෂයෙන්ම නිවනට අදාළ වෙනවා කෙලින්ම යොනිසෝ මනසිකාරය. ඉතින් අර යොනිසෝ මනසිකාරයට එන්න අවශ්‍ය කරන ට්‍රැන්කියුලිටි. අදාළ මොකද්ද වගේ මේ මහත්තර තේරෙන්නේ නැත්නම් ඔක්කොම තේරෙන්නේ බින්දිෂන් කියන කමන්නද? මේකට හරි සිංහල හොඳට තියාගෙන ඉඳලා තියෙනවා මෙහෙම ඉන්නේ. මගේ සිංහල කම නැති නේද? අර ඉතින් මේක තාමත් තියෙනවා. සවුත් ඇෆ්‍රිකා. මම ඉතින් වයසත් වෙන්නේ සමහර අවුරුදු 14 15 ඉස්කෝලේ ටික යනකොට මේ එක එක නගේ අනුරද මන් දන්නෙත් නෑ. ඒක I'm sorry I don't want to be I'm sure they all understand English, you know. So I like to. Is it okay? Come on, brother. You can attend that. Sing it. Okay, do. අද අර ගොඩක් අය කියන එකට ෆීල් වෙන්නේ සිංහලෙන් කියවන්න නේද? ඒක කොහොමද අය මට කිව්වද ඒක? මම මෙතන. මම ඉංග්‍රීසියෙන් කියවන්නද? මට මෙහෙට ඇවිල්ලා සිංහලෙන් කතා කරන්න කොහොමද? මම ගිර කරලා හිටියා වගේ ලංකාවේ. කමන්නේ නැනේ.
මම
තාමත් ඉංග්‍රීසියෙන් කියවන්න තියෙනවා නේද? හරි. ඔය අතේ he was asking about, you know, whether you had any previous merits for Nibbana to be achieved. Because in Sri Lanka there is a sort of a kind of idea that you know, you have to accumulate a lot of merits to, because we lack merits that we are not experiencing Nibbana.
Yes.
I don't think so. Actually, we lack the practice. Nibbana, I think we have more than enough merits. We lack the technique, the skill, the practice. And how to do it practically and make our mind tranquil. It's not that we have a lot of work and all that. It's that we have not, you know, learned to bring the meditation into our day-to-day movements, activities. And then we learn to, and to sense control, that's another one. And to know the danger of senses, I mean sense distraction, and learn to, you know, have the sort of, because from it starts from a small impression. I'm going to sense control slowly. You learn to go here and there, here, seeing this and that. Okay, then slowly the body also starts to make certain, you know, hormones or whatever. And then it goes into a bigger activity. So now this has happened. So we have to learn to how to go when you are driving a car, when you are walking, how to, you know, sort of choose what we are experiencing. And then how to relax and not to be tired, to check as I do this exercise just now, as you should master this. How just to be conscious of, now okay, for example, take this, and the other thing I was telling was that you have to have, it's called Yoniso Manasikara in the Pali language, but that is actually to have intuitive, how to activate intuitive knowledge. And that is a kind of a stillness and thinking, without thinking. A thought without a thought.
I explained that the other night.
Yes, sir.
When you were talking about the man driving the car.
Yes.
He's driving the car and he's looking, but he's not actually looking at everything, doing other things.
Yes.
The driving just comes naturally, and he's thinking, doing other things at the same time. He's not just concentrating on looking at the road and doing this.
Yes, and also he knows to look what is really necessary, and then he's keeping focus of the present moment, feeling the seat. Feeling, and if there's any planning and all that, he will not do that, because what is the, you just do one time the planning, not all the time.
That's right.
And wait for the result to, you know, sort of give, I mean, like result oriented sort of planning, you know, and then wait for the result. So you're not living in the moment, you know, you're drawn and your energies are just drained out. So this should not happen. This is untrained mind. And you know, the other one I was telling about not looking here and there was, is sense control. Like when you're crossing a road, you don't look who is inside the vehicle. You look at the vehicles, but you don't look who is inside. This kind of, this is a practice we have to do, and we should know that what is most attractive or this thing we must keep away. Now this is not easy, because normally we have to tell ourselves again and again, and then we have to also initially start early morning certain meditation, and then we must try to maintain. Now when ඉංග්‍රීසියෙන් කතා කරන කට්ටිය මොනවා බලනවා මෙහෙම කතා ඒක හැමතැනම මම දැක්කයි when I talk in English some of them, you know, they're slowly
going into it. I'm sorry
I cannot believe it.
We are the minority here to sort of like
because I am in the side of minority always.
We don't want to spoil
it. In Australia I was complaining, I'm coming to Australia to meet Australian people, not Sri Lankan people.
Yeah.
But now I got to know the organizers, they are connected to a certain community. So now I understand, but my determination is to penetrate one day, I hope, to share this peace to this, you know, community. Because my if I go to China, I want to do Chinese people. I'm not coming to go to some small Sri Lanka somewhere. But I'm joking, I'm so grateful to the people who have brought me here. But this is my intention, because I... already my heart, you know, why did I come all around? When I go walking also before the arms round, I go a small distance of walking. It is the blessing I want to give to the people. I mean, I know there's some power in the mind that, I must share with all these people. They're all suffering, and if we monks are not there for them, who is there? And even if they know it or not, that doesn't matter. And as a monk, we have at least some slight bit of Buddha's compassion, his mission with compassion that we must support. The Yoniso Manasikara is very important, but just one important practice. You must learn to remain in the present moment. This is something for a basic thing. I thought this you must train, you know. Like now when you are there, just you should be happy in the evening, you are just comfortable here. Whatever you have, you know, experienced, you should not bring it to this moment. Whatever some kind of thing to be expected, you should not bring that thought. Can you do that? Then karanna puluwan deka. මේ මොකද මේ දැන් යෝනිසෝ මනසිකාරය ඒවට එන්න නම් මේ චූටි දෙයට එන්න ඕනේ අපි ඒකට මේක කරාම when we are doing this we will not feel tired in our daily activity also because the reason when we anchor ourselves to the moment there's a place in our mind where we don't tap normally we don't notice that then බලන්න now you sit down here and you feel you are seated okay that means then you know that in there you know ගන්න බලන්න මේ පේන ටික විතරක් enjoy කරන්න Just enjoy what you're seeing only now. Park, if you're seated in a park, just think like that, now you're here. ගක්කරි සිතුවිල්ලක් එන්නේ නැනවා නේද? ඒක එනවා කියලා දැනගන්න. කොහෙන් if there's any thought going to come in, just note that there's a thought going to come or there is a thought if there is. But is that thought you? It came from nowhere. ඒක තමගේ හිතන්ද? සිතුවිල්ලක්ද? කොහෙන්වත් නැති තැනකින් ආවම නේද? බලන්න එක පොඩ්ඩක්. ඒ කියන්නේ මම කියලා හිතන්නේ ඔය මේ ඔක්කොම මේ ගැටෙන්නේ If all this confusion comes with this idea of ego, no, this thing, this thought, where is you? It came from nowhere and it's going, another one coming. And by that, Mahansi, relic, nothing on granting up. Why is it a common thing? Tikak, in the balan, no, but tikak. Just try to wait like that for some time. Then we'll be starting a journey. If anything, any thought tries to come, just watch that. And if you relax with that, you will even observe other things that you're breathing. It's not any meditation or anything, it's just a small step towards this real practice. You can remain that more and more, you will gather strength in your mind, you know. Make a wedding, wedding, vadanda pulana, then come prashna. Api prashna kwenne, moha pehmi inda pulana. You make it a prashna. This actually after that, this is very important in your daily practice. Now when you sit down, you get some strength. If you get tired, just wait like that and watch for some time. Start in the morning and continue that much as possible. little bit, you know, when you're walking and all these activities, gatte chite bhasite tumi bahe santajanya kayo dukkhu. So even to come to that, Buddha says, you know, when you're walking, moving, going, be mindfully comprehending. Not only mind, it's not, Sampajanya means a very, like Yoniso Manisikara, actually it is, means comprehending completely. Now that's where, to comprehend, you have to be really settled with observing the body. Even if you have Sampajanya, when you have to be able to Rupaskarga, Rupyatthekta, හිත මෙහෙම තැම්පත් වෙන්න ඕනේ නේ. ඉතින් අපි නිකන් මේ සූත්‍රයක් මෙහෙ කියවලා එතන ගලපන්න බැරි වෙන අපේ එතන අරව මේ වරි වෙන්නේ නැතුව දැන් මේක ඕන කෙනෙකුට වෙන්න බෑ. දැන් මට සමාජගත මම මේ කවුද අපේ මහත්වේදියා මේ කිව්වා වෙලාවේ දැන් මම දවල් කාලේ කියන්නේ මම භාවනාවක් කරගෙන ඉන්නකොට when I was doing this meditation in the room today in the afternoon suddenly I could, you know, there's a meditation where I'd be watching these things and then I'm going into a nice, like a, where I don't, there's no problem. It's all connected with the body and attachment to it and perception. This world is formed out of it. Now there's a practice where this, මම වැඩි ධර්මයේ ගොඩාක් කියලා දෙන්නේ යන්නේ නැහැ. මම මේ කඹයක් කල්ලන්න දෙන්නේ ඉක්මනට මේ ඇත්තට කරගෙන කට්ටියට මේක ගැලවෙගන්න. ඇත්තට මම ගොඩාක් මේ සූත්‍ර විස්තර කරන්නේ නැහැ. මම මේ ප්‍රැක්ටිකලි කෙලිම සබ්ජෙක්ට් එකට එන්න බලන එක බ්ලොක් කරන දේ අයින් කරන්න බලන එක. ඒ කියන්නේ මේ මේකට මේ මම කරන දේ තමයි මේ වෙන්නේ තමයි දැන් අර then what happen this practice is done. Where I watch this body, you know, at the daily I do this. Now, with the skanda, it started in 2004 when I faced in the jungle, all this wounded body in Nakhas range. And that no other meditation, even samadhi didn't work at that time. And it was only by, suddenly I remembered my teacher has told her to memorize this striking sutta. Then I remembered the Anatta Lakshana Sutta at that time. And then how to watch it, just to watch who you are, what is this body, body and the consciousness. So this I was practicing and immediately the pain disappeared. It's a long story how I cut across Nakhas range in 2004. So I think little bit I told that, that yeah, I was going from forest to forest, started from Kudumbigala, like that I was going from Ampara, all walking those days. We stayed night time in the monastery. At that time, there, this was the toughest one with all the niches, you know, and many things happened. Just this practice started there because there I was really damaged fully. And then some robbers, they found me inside the forest and they looked after me actually. If I didn't find them, you would not find me today. This was one of the situations there. Because you go here, there's miles and miles, no. It's just forest, no compass. Nakhas patch danna dana athule. Nakhas wala kalu pahana kiyala hala thiyena adu widiyala. Athule thiyena dawas deyak athule everything one ithan denna. Gama
patthara wenna kara me. Meemure gama thiyena.
Meemuren ehema ekak eka athule meema kalu pahana kiyala seeker ekak thiyena me. E
patthali wage kandala swamana.
Athule naha meka nikan me nakhas meema ithwasen nakhas estate ekata wetenna puluwa. නගල පැත්තේ.
ඒ කියන්නේ විස්තන් පැත්තේ
නේ. විස්තන් පැත්තේ පව් කරන් ගියාම මේ ඔය දැන් නගල තියෙන පල්ලේගම.
ආ පල්ලේගම.
අන්න ඒ පැත්තෙන් ඔය කැලි අතරින් තමයි ඔය නකස් ස්ටේට් පැත්ත. ඒක
අලිහෙමත් ඉන්නද?
ඔව් අලි නම් නගලනේ. මෙතන ඉන්නේ මේ කඳු වාසේ කැලි මහ කැලි. ඔය කමාන්ඩෝස් ටයිම් ට්‍රේන් කරන්න තමයි දාන්නේ. ඒක දාලා රෙෂන්ස් උත් එක්ක. ඉතින් okay, then there only I got this terrible, you know, I had a very tough time. But I was very lucky also. And there is this practice of watching myself and see who am I, really. There's no self, this body. The practice of anatta, you know, the Buddha says there's no self, this sutta. This, I was reading it. I was like, you know, really weak and like this. And I was sort of reciting it and applying. Soon the pain was going away. So after that only every day I do it. Whenever I have slept and woke up, I used to do this. He said, well, this, you know, little bit I demonstrate in the end of the program, you know. I take part by part here and how I like to watch yourself and to observe and then spreading it to metta. This practice I demonstrate in every program. Just to give you an idea, if you read the original sutta, how to apply it to yourself. So you look at your whole, your experience through the Dhamma, through the words of the enlightened master. So you don't identify with this, you know, changing phenomena. Last වෙන දේවල් එක තමයි වැඩි සම්බන්ධකම් කරගන්න යන්නේ. ඒක බලනවා. එතකොට මේ මාස්ක් එක ගලවන වැඩක් තමයි වෙන්නේ. ඉතින් මේක දේශනාවෙන් ගැඹුරට කියන්නේ මේ හිත තැම්පත් වුණා when you get tranquil with the original teaching, there could be an intuitive experience. This is also another step. Now if you hear my bana only, my discourse, I don't expect that will happen. So I'm very happy. Actually, this happened in Switzerland. Suddenly, I don't know how we met also. One family came running to me there. And this gentleman said, Pante, I was listening to your YouTube, this thing after that, and reading all the suttas, Majjhima Nikaya. I was so happy. This is what I should hear. If I hear from them that they are listening to more of my YouTube, that means they have not got my real message. Because this is my this thing to guide them to see the Buddha. Don't rely. You don't know which monk is coming. What is he telling? How much he has realized? Whether that will really take you to the final goal? You must associate. Otherwise, you have to get some. Each one they have time to practice and they have some experience. So you have to get that experience. But if he's really sincere, he will direct you to this. My teacher's words actually. That will direct you to the original words, the Buddha, the suttas. Not to read the whole thing, just take few of this, what is applicable, even Satipatthana Sutta, Ate Gate Chite Bhasite, this part even, and when you're walking, you know, Sampajana, you have to know what it is. So that normally, now some of the things, you don't think it just becomes clear. If it's not becoming clear, that means your mind is not pure enough. Simply that. So without that purity, you try to squeeze the understanding becomes, the effect becomes distorted. You get it? And a lot of people, they try to sort of connect with other suttas and so many other descriptions and so on. So there, when you look at the whole sutta pitaka, you see Buddha, he didn't teach some of the things until these people were mature. It took maybe 10 years, 20 years, like Rahula Kumar, you know. After the first two sermons, it took some years. Then he Buddha saw how he's mature. And then he went and spoke about the five skandhas which lead to Nibbana. So today we just don't have such a master, but at least we must repeat, reread, note what is striking. But most important is to just one verse, even apply it in. If someone is shouting at you, not to shout back. Just see this, the sound only. Just make it practical, no point otherwise. Having a lot of knowledge, if you can't, you know, use it to see the world where it will not make you suffer. I can't react to it. එයවත් නිවන එයට තියෙන විකෘති අදහස් වලින් හිත නිවන ශක්තියක් එනවා. එක දවසක් one day I was, you know, my father has parked the car and I, that was in Vellavatte long years back as a boy. Suddenly, not a boy means I already now changed, you know, I was practicing that time. So suddenly I was in the front seat and I don't drive the car. Suddenly one lady came, it was parked somewhere, my father has gone to pick up something. She came and she started scolding, I mean shouting, something. and not to park there or something. The dogs know, sign beware of dogs, and she's more worse than a dog. Well, she just started shouting and she went. And when she shouted, I told the prophet, sorry auntie, when my father comes, I will move the car. Like that, I just told her something. And she went, just shout, and then she went. She came back again. And he said that normally when I shout, they shout at me. But you didn't shout. Where are you, son? Where are you from? And, what was it? You can keep the car, it's okay. Okay, but these people, like that, you have to remember. This is very powerful, you know, very powerful. If you cool the system down, it is actually the reaction is because you are having the same defilement you see from outside. Like, you know, feces or something. You know, you have it inside your stomach, no problem. But when it's outside, you don't really like it. So close to you. So same way, defilements when you see in others, they are behaving the same thing you're having. That's why you don't like to see that. I thought I had some question.
What is your question? Raise your question. Ask him, raise the question.
If you have something really. I thought today really, I'm like now today, this moment is like the emergency ward, you know? Expecting people who have some really problems, they could come. And if you have Dharma problems, so also, I'll tell you. හරි හරි දැන් දෙතිර නම් තමයි වර පුළුවන් දෙයක් තේරුම් ගන්න බෑ. දැන් අපි දැන්
අපි දැන් මේ කර්මයද මේ අපි හැමෝටම බලපාන්නේ කියන්නේ අපි එක එක සලවලින් සහ අපේ තරහ යන එක උනත් අපිට පාලනය කරගන්න බැරි වෙන කර්ම බලපාන.
ඒ කියන්නේ මම හිතන මොඩ් එකක නෙමෙයි ඉන්නේ. මම ආවේ නිකන් ගාවක වගේ. කර්මය යම් ප්‍රමාණයකට අපේ තියෙන එන්වයරන්මන්ට් එක බලපානවා. හැබැයි අපි ඒ අර දැන් එන්වයරන්මන්ට් එකනේ කර්මයෙන් ගේන්නේ. කර්ම විපාක කියලා කියන්නේ ඇත්තටම මේ ශරීරයයි ඒ තලය. තලය කියන්නේ වැඩ කරන තියෙන ඔෆිස් එකක් කියමුකෝ, පවුලේ වටපිටාවක් කියමුකෝ. ඉතින් ඇත්තටම ඉස්සර දැන් කේන්ති ගස්සල වටපිටාවක් කියමුකෝ නිතරම. එතකොට අපි දුන්න කේන්තියක් තමයි ආයේ එන කේන්තියක් වෙන තැනකට යන්නේ. ඉතින් අපි රෆ් එකට දැන් එක කෙටින් ටැග් විස්තර කරලා තිනවා බුදුහාඳුරු තැන්වලදී අර මෙහෙම තමන් රෆ් එකට හිටපු තැන්වල රෆ් තලයකට පහල වෙනවා. ඒක රෆ් තලේ රෆ් මේ ගුරුසු ස්පර්ශ වෙනවා. ඒ ස්පර්ශයෙන් ගුරුසු දැනීම වෙනවා. ඒ විදිහට අර දැනෙන දැනීමක් නැති කරවන්නේ. ඉතින් ගොඩක් විට දැනීම නිකන් විස්තර කරන ගොඩක් අය දැනීම දක්වා පෙර විපාක කියලා. ඒ දැනෙන එක සංඥා කරන හැටි සංඥා වෙච්ච විදිහටම සංකාර කරනවා. ඒක වෙන්නේ. ඒක අපිට වෙනස් කරන්න පුළුවන්. ඒක තමයි අපිට වෙනස් කරන්න තියෙන්නේ. ඊට පස්සේ කොච්චර වේදනාවක් ආවත් ඒක දැනෙනත්වයක් ඇති කරන්න පුළුවන් ඒ ධර්ම සංඥා ඇති කරගන්න. එනන්නේ දෙ කියන්නේ. එතකොට ඒක ඒවා අනිත් එක තමයි දැනෙන්නේ අපි කිලුටු වෙච්ච තරමට ඇතුළේ. අපි පිරිසුදු නම් I'm sorry. දැන් අපිට දෙක දෙපැත්තක් අපි පිරිසුදු නම් මේ එහෙම ඒක දැනෙන්නේ නැති ගතියක් එන්න ඕනේ එන්නේ. එතන එක ගානක් නැහැ. අපි කිලුටු ගතිය තියෙනකොට තමයි සෙන්සිටිව් වැඩි වෙන්නේ. මේ කර්ම විපාකම කියන්නේ කේන්තිගේ මට කර්ම එහෙම වෙන්නම තියනවා කියලා කියන එක තමයි. ඒක කාය පුරාණං කම්ම කියන අபிසංකතං අபிසංචේතං යතං එකනේ අපි සංස්කාර කළා අපු හැටි තමයි මේ පුරාණ කර්ම විපාක මේක ආයතනය නිකන් මේක ඉන්ස්ට්‍රුමන්ට් එකක් ඒ කියන්නේ එතකොට මේක සායු එහෙම හැදිලා මේ විදිහට this body is a instrument you know so actually so it is there to for support consciousness and with consciousness you are feeling perception you know mainly the in consciousness the main factor is feeling දැනීම තමයි main factor එක විඥාන එතකොට ඒ ඔක්කොම තුනම හතරම එකට තියෙනවා. ඒක වෙන් කරන්න පුළුවන් එකක් නෙමෙයි. ඒක අර භාග්‍යතුන් වහන්සේගේ මේ ඥානියට ඒක වෙන් කළා. මෙයා කළා ඒ ෆැක්ටර්ස් හතරක් තියෙ. වේදනා, සංඥා, සංකාර, ඥාන ඔය හතරම මේ එකට තමයි පහළ වෙන්නේ. ඉතින් දැන් මේක දැනීම දැන් ගොඩක් කටි විග්‍රහ ගන්න කැමති ඔබ දැනීම දක්වා පෙර විපාක එහෙම කියලා. ඒක ගොඩක් කොහොම මේ කොහොමද රියැක්ට් වෙන්නේ එක අපේ අතේ තියෙන්නේ. ඒත් අපි රියැක්ට් වෙන්නේ කොහොමද සංඥාවන්නේ? සංඥාව සංඥා වෙන එක තමයි මේ ධර්ම සංඥා. අපි එහෙම ඇති කරගෙන යනකොට අර රියැක්ට් වෙන එක නැචරලි ඔටෝමැටිකලි the way we react will change according to the way we perceive. So we change the perception by having more dharma visions. Sati sampajanya ati karanne dharma vision ekak it makes with this practicing satipatthana of looking at yourself and seeing it from another angle, it makes you have the dharma vision. And like for example, someone is shouting, you know, scolding. If you say take it as somebody, it looks, you know, like a shouting at you. But if you see it, hear it as a sound, and just a sound vibration, and then you have, you know, the ear. If you studied before that, if you watch carefully, you know, they're just momentary experiences, and consciousness comes then and goes again. So if you are now just now like you were observing. If you observe just still yourself, now this is necessary. මොහොම අල්පියක් මෙහෙම ඉන්න එක ඕනේ හැම මේක දැක බලා ගන්න දැනගන්න නැත්නම් මේක හැම වෙලාවම මේ බනහඳ වැඩක් වෙනවා. මේක හැම වෙලෙම මේක මේ මොහොතට අපේ පුරුද්දකට ගේන්න වෙනවා. ඒතකොට තමයි අර පොඩ්ඩ අපිටම ප්‍රත්‍යක්ෂ වෙන වෙලාවක් එනවා මේ දැනුණා දැන් කොහොමද නැති වුණා ඒවත් ටිකක් මිනී කරන්න කල්පනාව ගියාම ඊයේද පෙරේදනේ
ඊයේ
අර ප්‍රෝග්‍රෑම් එකට ආවා. ඒක හැබැයි මම කිව්වා ඇරේ ඔළුව චංචල වෙන ඔක්කොම වැඩපිළිවෙල ඒ කියන්නේ දැන් ඒ කියන්නේ Brahmacharya වෙන ගැටලු මම කිව්වා. ඒ කියන්නේ ගොඩක් ඉතින් ඉන්දිය සමහර දැන් මේවත් එක්ක ගොඩාක් අපි අර සතිය ඒ ඔක්කොම මොකද වෙන විශාල පැත්තක් ඇරෙනවා. විශාල විරුද්ධ පැත්තක් ඇරෙනවා අර නිින්දනවලදී. දෙන්නත් දැන් ඉතින් ඒවත් එක්ක මේ විමුක්තිය යන පැත්ත සෑහෙන බ්ලොක් එකක්. එතකොට කැමත් එක්කත් එන්නේ අද මේ මහත්තයෙක් හොඳට තේරෙන්නේ ඇත්තටම මම සතුටුනා පොඩ්ඩක් අර එයා කෙලිස් ගොඩක් නේද හම්බුනේ කියලා. ඒ කියන්නේ හරි මේ කැම මේ රස ගන්නකොට ඒකෙන් දැන් මේ වයස තියදී හදාගන්න එක වටනවා. Better when you have time to quickly rectify this. Because as you go on you become a personality which is useless, you know. That is, you look so inconsiderate and petty minded. ඔක්කොම මේ හරි හැදිච්ච නැති කට්ටියක් වෙලා තමයි නාකිනකොට අපි දකින්න කට්ටි ගොඩක් ඉගෙන පව් ඉතින් අර කවුරු කියන්නේ හිටියේ නෑ ඒ කාරණාම හරි ගස්ස ගන්න. හැබැයි එසිනේ මේ ඉතින් අර හැමෝටම මේක අපි දැම්මම වෙනසක් කර ගන්න ඕනේ. එතකොට when you are going getting older and older you become more, you know, beautiful. But I don't know, he seems to have been lived a good life, you know. If you look quite a nice man. Nice person. Yeah, because these inclinations of spirituality already there from young age. In the subconscious.
අnder sati sampajanne ekak me kiyu wadak karanne dan udahadura sama sutra wala kiyana pratipadawak kala me mulin indriya sangwara sangwara ඊපස්සේ me
iriya pate bodhana matanne
ajalaka mokala kalaka mokala sutra ehema kiyanne thi etakote e wage dan satiyen patang ganna dan etra sammadittiya kiyana eka samahara දේශනාවල කියනවා සම්මාදිට්ඨිය ප්‍රකට කරගෙන තමයි මේ ගමනේ යනුනේ කියලා. නමුත් තවත් සමාතන්වල තියෙනවා සිහියෙන් පටන් අරගෙන ඊට පස්සේ එතකොට අර දැන් ඒ නුවණ කියන එක ඥාණය අර සම්මාදිට්ඨිය වැඩෙන්න සතියෙන් හිටියාම ඒක හොඳ ඒ කියන්නේ
ඒක වෙනස් සෙපරේට් කරන්න බෑ.
නෑ නේද?
ඒක කොහොම ඒ කියන්නේ සතියයි සම්මාදිට්ඨියයි ඒව මේ එකක කොටස් මේ වල ෆන්ක්ෂන්ස් වල මේ සතිය හැම වෙලෙම තියෙනවා. ඔයලස ප්‍රමාණවල වලට ඒ කියන්නේ පොර සම්මාදිට්ඨියත් යම් ප්‍රමාණයක සම්මාදිට්ඨිය ඕනේ තමයි නිකන් තියරිටික නොලෙජ් එක. ඊට පස්සේ ප්‍රැක්ටිස් කරන් මේ ප්‍රැක්ටිකලි යනකොට තමන්ගේ චරිතයත් සුද්ධ වෙවි. චර්යා ධර්මනේ ඒ කියන්නේ ඉරියාපතේ භෝජන මතන්නේ ඔය ටික. ඔය චර්යා ධර්මයේ ඒ ටික තමයි ගොඩක්ම මේ අපිට ලැක් වෙන්නේ. සමාකය දැන් මන්දර සමාක වාද එනවා අර සමාකර විඥානේ මෙහෙම තේරුම් ගත්තම මේක හිස් වෙනවා කියලා එකපාරටම නිවන දැක්කා වගේ. දෙන්නත් දන්නේ. ඒවත් දැකලා තියෙනවද දන්නේ නැහැ. මොකද මම දන්නවද කාලීනව හොඳයි එමු හිතන එක මම නම් කැමති. ඒ ශුන්‍යතාවය පිළිබඳ මේ විඥානේ එක කෙලින්ම අපි රියලයිසේෂන් එක වචන වලින් ගන්න බලනවා. ඒකත් හොඳයි මුල් අවදී. හැබැයි ඒක එහෙම ගත්තම නිවනක් කියන එක වැරදි. අපේ මේ අර කොච්චර පිළිවෙලව දීලා තියෙනවනේ. ඉන්න ඕන විදි ඉදි තොට හිත තැන්පත් වෙන එක වැඩිකම වැඩි වෙච්ච තරමට තමයි ඥානේ මේ මට්ටම් තියනවා තේරෙන. ඒ තේරෙන මට්ටම් තියනවා දැන් මෙහෙම තේරුණා කියලා තේරෙන එක මට්ටමදී. සමාධි ඊට පස්සේ තව තියෙනවා මේ මේ එහෙම ඇතුලේ අරලා එන එකක් තියෙනවා ඒවා තියෙනවා. ඔය ධම්ම ඇස කියලා කියනවා. ඒවා නිකන් ඒවා නෙමෙයි ඔය වචන කියන එක නෙමෙයි මේ අර ටිකක් අර අපේ පිරිසුදු මට්ටමක් කාම එන්න ඕනේ. මේ අඩුම ගන්න එකක් අපි දකින්න ඕනේ. ඒවා හරියට එනවනම් ආව එන පැත්තට යනවනම් අපේ අඩු ගන්න චරිතය වෙනස් වෙන්න ඕනේ. අඩු ගන්න එකම දේ තමයි උණ බහින්න ඕනේ. රාග දෝෂ මොහ අපේ අඩු වෙවි යන්න ඕනේ. ඒක නැතුව ඒක තමයි එක යාජ්ස්ටික් එකක්. අපිට කියන්න බෑ මේ එක අපි දිහා බලනකොටත් ඒක වෙන්න ඕනේ. අපි වෙන කෙනෙක් හරි අපි අනිත් අය බලන්නේ කොහොම අවශ්‍යම නෑ. යා මොන ඵලයක් නැද්ද ඒක ඒක හොඳ නෑ. අඩු ගන්න අපි දිහා හරි බලාගෙන යන්න. මේක ඉම්පෝර්ටන්ට් ඉඳට වඩා මට කේන්ති අඩුද මේකෙන්. එතකොට මේ දිශාව හරි. හැබැයි ඒක නම් කරන්න යන්නේ නැහැ. මේක සෝවාන් වුණාද මෙයා වුණාද ඒකත් බලන්නක. I'm sorry, I wish I could have, you know. Mother, then, you know, I was just explaining. He was asked, what the Mahathaya will?
Pratipada,
yeah. He was asking me whether with you, you know, like Sammaditti, you know, like right view and Sati, whether these two, like there are so many ways, you know, like some say that, that you know, there's a normal way that you must have some degree of right view first. That means like knowing the map. And some idea, but then after that, by practicing, by purification, you have the final right view. As a vision. So those visions come, they are also levels of it, you know, that because there are some teachings where you explain and they think they have come to that realization. So that's okay, but there's a process of purification, of conduct. And with that process of evolution, you have a deeper experience of that inside. So one way to check that you had these experiences, you have there should be a change in your life, correct? If someone is scolding at you or something, this thing, or you should get less angry, less greedy. That means the symptoms of your disease, the defilement, that should, you know, the decrease. So that is a real yardstick to find out whether you are really progressing. Otherwise, no point. You have a lot of knowledge or even some clarity, but it doesn't do any change in your system. It's no point. That's why even if you go to some maybe bar or something, you are not scolding after that, better you go there. You have no desire. Because finally it is that, you know, that's the exam. And no,
ඒක සම් ඉතින් එතන මත්පස්නක් ආව එතන සම්මාදිට්ඨිය තිබුණා නම් ඒක සුමුද ඇටි වෙච්ච හැටි දන්නවා නම් අපිට ඒක මේ එතනින් ඒක තේරුම් ගන්න පුළුවන්. නමුත් ඒ අර මුලින් සීලයක පිළිපහිටුවාම අර ඒ ඉන්ද්‍රිය ඉස්සල සංවර කරගත්තාම අර තව ඉලෙවල් ලෙවල් එකට යන්න පුළුවන්. So that you understand more next level than this.
So ඒ එතකොට සීලය පරිපූර්ණ වෙලා එන සමාධියෙන් බලනකොට ඒකයි එන්නේ වෙන නොලෙජ් එක. අරක කැඩීගෙන එනකොට එන්නේ එකක් දැන් ගොඩක් අය එකනේ කරන්නේ සාමාන්‍ය අද කාලීනව වෙන්නේ ගොඩක්ම මගෙන් අහන ප්‍රශ්න තමයි හාමුදුනේ අයි මේක දැක්ක දැනුණා අනිත්‍ය මෙනි කරා එහෙමත් හොඳයි බැරිම වෙච්ච තැන හැබැයි ඊට වඩා අර ඉන්ද්‍ර සංවර සීලය දීලා තියෙන්නේ ඒ වගේ අර එතනින්වත් අපි ස්පර්ශයේ නොවි ඒ කියන්නේ මේ එක්ස්පීරියන්ස් එකක් නොවි මේ හය සමාධියකට එක්තැන් වීමකට ඇති වෙලා එන ඥානය. එහෙම ඥාන තියෙනවා නේ. කියන්නේ එහෙම තමයිතොට පංච නිවර්ණයන් මේක બ્લોක් කරන්නේ ඥානෙන්ද? එක සප්තමනේනේ කෙලින්ම වැඩ කරන්නේ. ඉතින් දිගඹුරේ මොකක් හරි වෙන්න නම් අර විදිහට සීලේ පරිපූර්ණ වෙලා යන එක. ඉතින් අර කෑමගෙන ආයි බලන්න ඕනේ මොකද්ද මේ සුවඳ කියලා. අරකින් බේරිලා. එතකොට තේරෙනවා මේක මේ එතකොට හොඳට තේරෙනවා අර නිකන් මත්ෙච්ච ඔළුවකින් නෙමෙයි. මත්ෙච්ච ඔළුවකින් පැහැදිලිව පේන්නේ. ඉතින් අපි හිතන අර වැඩි දින අපේ ශක්තිය අපි දිනු කළ තිනවා මදි අර ඉන්ද්‍රිය සංවර සීලේ ඒ මට්ටමට වදන්න. අපි කියනවා මේ යන්දර යන්නේ කියලා يعني වදන හැටි ඒක පාළියෙන් කියලා බුදුහාමුදුර කියලා කියනවා. එනේ තොරතුරු හොයන්නේ නැහැ. ෂේප් එක එක සුවඳ නසුඳ පැති වලින් ඒක ඔක බේසික් ප්‍රැක්ටිස්ස් වගේ. ඔකට කෝටිය සංවර සීලේ රකින්නවා කියලා කියන්නේ ඉන්ද්‍රිය සංවර සීලේ. මොකක්ද?
ඒක රකින එක.
එක මේ ඕන දෙයක් කරන්න නැති ඉඳලා කරන්න යනකොට අමාරුයි තමයි. ඒ මම ඉදා කිව්වේ දැන් මම මෙහෙම පේනකොට මෙහෙම පේනවා. මෙහෙම බලනකොට ඔක්කොරහින්. හැබැයි ඉතින් මේවා හදලා තියෙන්නේ දැන් ඉස්සර ඔය කියන්න ඕනේ නෑ බුදුහාමරේ මුල් කාලේ. බලන්න ඔක්කොම ස්වාමි මාසෙ කට්ටක් ගාලා එක්ස්පීරියන්ස් කරා. දැන් මේක කඩ කඩ කියන හැබැයි අර තලයේ කින්නවනම් දැන් කමක අපි මොකක් හරි මානසික සුවයකින් ඉන්නවනම් මේක නැචරල් එතකොට. තේරුම් ගන්නෑ. මේ තේරුම් කර කර කියන්න ඕනේ නැහැ. දැන් මේක වැටිලා ඉන්නකොට මේක උඩ වෙනව නගින්ද? උඩ නැගලා ඉන්නකොට අර කිඹෙම වෙලා. තේරුම් ගන්නෑ. ඈ? දැන් අපි ඒකේ සනීපේ තලයේ ඉන්නවනම් ඒක දැන් මේක තියෙන එක තැනකට එන්න. අර කාම ලෝකේ දේවල් ඩිස්ට්‍රැක්ට් වෙන හින්දා. ඒ කියන්නේ අපේ විඥානේ මෙහෙම ඇදලා ගන්න හින්දා ඒක මෙහෙම මග අරගෙන එනකොට සමාධිගත වෙනවා. ධානයකට. ධාන හරි එහෙම මතු වෙන්න පුළුවන්. ඒක සමාධිගත. දැන් එතන ඉන්න කෙනාට මේක ඔබ්වියස්. දැන් එතකොට ඒකේ දාලා තියෙනේ කියලා තියෙන එක ඕනෙත් නෑ. ඒකට සම්බන්ධ වෙන්නේත් නෑ. මම දන්නේ මම කියන්නේ ධ්‍යාන රමයක් කියලා මොනවත් මම එහෙම කියන්නේ නෑ. හැබැයි දැන් මම ඒ වැන්නවත් තවතනක වඩිනකොට මට එකයි අර දැන් ඒස් මම භාවනා කරගෙන ඉඳලා මේ විදියට වඩින්නේ මේ වෙලාවේ. ඒ වඩනකොට හොඳට තේරෙනවා අරවා විසක් හැටියට දකින්න ටක් ගාලා. දැන් ඒව එන්නෙම නෑ ඔළුවට. ඒකට ලාවට එනකොටම දකින්නේ අරකට ඔපොසිට් විසක්. තොර කොහෙවත් භුක්ති විඳින්න යන්නේ නෑ. තමයි එක දාලා නම් තරවිලා මේ යන හින්දා මේ වැඩිලා රෙන්නේ මම ඒක මේ නිකන් භුක්ති විඳින්නේ නෑ රසක් ඒක රසක් නේ ඔකෙන් බලන්නේ මේ රසයෙන් තව වෙන රසයක් කියන්නේ එතකොට
සාමාන්‍ය මනසෙක් කියන්නේ දුක සුවයක් කියන
ඔව් ඒක ධර්මයේ හරිය දැන් මම මෙනි කරන් යනවා කියන්නේ අර ඒක එක්ස්පීරියන්ස් කරගෙන ඒක ට්‍රයි කරන්න එක ඉම්පෝර්ටන්ට්
අම්මුලේ අපි මේ හැමදේම පුරුදු කරන්නේ අතාරින්ද නෑ අපි ඒව දැඳීම අඩු කරගන්න කියන ඒ concept එකනේ අපි මේ අනුගමනය කරන්නේ ඉතින් අපි
අතාරින්ද කියන්නේ මොකද
ඒ කියන්නේ කොහොමද
දෙයක් කියන්නේ හින්දා
දුකක් කියන හින්දා ඒනට හම්බුනේ දැන් අපි ළමයි එක ඉන්නේ අපිට මට දුර දැන කිව්වොත් අපි දැන් ඒ දෙන්නට දැන් අපි මේ සමාජ රටාවක් තියෙනවා යන ක්‍රමයක් ඒගොල්ලෝ ස්ටඩිස් කරන්න ඒවා achieve කරන්න දේවල් තියෙනවා තන අපි ළමයි වේවට යොමු කරලා අපි අතාරින්න ප්‍රැක්ටිස් කරද්දී ඒ ළමයි ඒවට බැඳෙන්න යොමු කරනවා. එතකොට අපි කොහොමද ওই දෙක බැලන්ස් කරන්නේ?
ඔය ප්‍රශ්නෙට අවිවේකানন্দ ස්වාමීගේ මම මේ ඉදා හිටියක් දැන්න. මේ මහත්තයා හිටියේ.
අපි හිටියක්
මත මෙන්න අඳුමක් කනන්නේ තියෙනවා. දැන් මම කියවනේ අර මොකද විවේකানন্দ ස්වාමී මේ කොහෙද අර සීනි කන්දපා කියලා I'm sorry, okay, sorry, you're missing something. Just I was telling that, you know, he's asking how to balance, you know, his family. That they can, I'm telling about letting go, all these things. But then how to balance it with their children and so on, I understand. And I understand means I understand his problem, but I don't understand it in a personal way because I have not that experience.
Yes.
So I saw Swami Vivekananda, you know, that time I told about the, he told how he come after 10 days and then he stopped eating, you know, sugar and then he told. So I don't know what to do to him. Maybe I'll have to get married and then find out.
more wisdom and more knowledge.
But I can... how to tell this? I can only tell according to I had a little experience with my family and with my, you know, I was doing a job also for 2 years. So that time I noticed that, you know, and even in the family, okay, I will tell you, my brother had a problem, you know. I have one brother, he was like one time 14-15, he went astray a little bit. But I had some idea about it also already. Because when you're getting detached, you'll have more energy. Detached means, you know, you'll have more energy to really do the right thing for the family and everybody. But when you're attached, you're draining a lot of energy. So sometimes, you know, now I had a great-grandmother who when the son was dying, she had no tear in her eyes. She was, you know, like using having a japamala and like this rosary, and she was chanting in front of a Buddha statue. And then she used to be very close to my mother. My mother was small then, so she used to tell, "This is how you practice." You know, in the Satipatthana, we have the mindful meditation where you see a dead body for 10 occasions, like how it decomposes. And then those pictures she used to show my mother. So that means she has been practicing these things. That's why she had detachment from the sun. Mm-hmm. She was very old, she was a very pious lady. So these are the things they did. Then they were able to, you know, not with emotion, they did their... that father or a mother becomes an enlightened father. An enlightened member in the family will be a great blessing. Even after you die, you know, you'll be going to a good place which you serve the people, serve your family. That will be your insurance policy. Otherwise, you will be a ghost coming, you know, asking for merit or haunting because you couldn't leave your child, you couldn't leave your husband or wife. You understand? So this is something in the long run, it is very, I think, very important wisely, and also you feel you are at peace, you know, but not easy. I can't tell you strongly because I didn't have that bondage of being a father, you know. I can see father, you know, I don't have attachment to my father, but I can see my father still, he's having so much attachment to me. I can only relate to someone who did, my great grandma. That's all I could, so I don't want to talk about it too much. Because I don't know, if I was a father, how I would manage, I don't know. but I could say you should try. And only thing, several people think that, you know, these attachments, this lot of work is the reason we can't. No, I don't think, because I think you have not opened that part of the brain. This is what I say, you don't put enough time for just little bit focusing and go doing the thing. You think it's a simple thing, I rush. No, that makes a big difference if you stop and little bit wait, and then do. Wait, do. Like that. You understand? Even in the way that you just stop sometime and see, let me watch. And then you see that inner peace is increasing after that. And when you experience that in a certain way, you will never give up this practice. You see, it's a high dosage you're pumping into your brain. Just waiting and not putting anything into, adding to that. You're just entering into mindfulness. Feeling, waiting for the moment where you're feeling the breathing. Stop in the car and just stop and do that. And then do that after another session. How much fast work you have, you learn to break and you learn another peaceful part of your life in your brain. And you know, this was all, now say if I didn't change at the age of 18, I would be by now, you know, I mean, even I was getting so angry, so irritated. I mean, he was telling that he used to keep the anger and, you know, sort of suddenly, and now it's also keeping the anger when you don't react first, second, third time. But fourth time you react with triple impact. But those days I don't speak. I used to hit people. No speaking. It was a kick or a punch. So after some time, everybody knew I was a useless, you know, like, my God, this one is there. And only caning from the teachers. So this was the kind of, but then if it went on without the change of consciousness, mind, I mean, I would have been now like a mafia or something, I don't know what. First would have been in the army, then would have been like that. But then if you get that piece of, that understanding, then you do the work also, you will never miss this because this is your main work. I always think like this, you know, the greatest sin you will do in this life is not to know the secret of life. Not knowing this and just dying, you know. It's going to be the worst thing you'll be doing to your life. And if you get little bit awakened, it's going to awaken your family relations, all their karma is going to get burst off. But we are now looking, you know, just trying to solution from our unenlightened mind. So if I have a problem, that I do, of course. If I would say my brother, you know, he went, something happened in age of 14, 15. But I already knew, because of my life, you know, I'm already, that by that time I had these certain connections. Already knew this age, he will have this problem. 14, 14-15, he's 9 years younger to me. So already then, when it came, I knew it was a karmic problem. My father, he had the wrong friends coming. I just slowly, and then, and I'm the one who's noticed the problem in first, because I was doing walking meditation, you know, I used to come from the island hermitage. That time, as Upasak, I used to come and go, because my parents called me, then I go back. Like, this was another period. So then when I was walking in the balcony, and my brother's room is, you know, like on one side, and I don't know, he's not going to YouTube anything, nothing, no? Is it going on?
No.
I don't know, I don't know, YouTube is going on. I don't know, make a person with you again. I don't know, make a මගේ එකක්වත් නැහැ මේ ගෲප් එකට. ඔක්කොම මේ මම ඉස්සර ඉඳ දෙන්නෙම නැහැ මේවා. මේක දැන්නම් දෙන්නේ කොකොටම යන විදියක් යනවා නම් මේක රෙකෝඩ් කරන්න කියලා තමයි දෙන්නේ. මේක මන්දි ගැන කිය කමන්න දෙන්න.
කලින් ආමතුරෝ එක වීඩියෝ එක සඳහන් කරලා දෙතරි
මල්ලි
ගැන කියලා දෙන්න.
මංගගේ ශක්ති ඔක්කොම තියෙන ඒ පැත්තට යන්න පුළුවන් හැබැයි අර යම් දේවල් පහල තියෙන්නේ එහෙම ගොඩක් අය ඉන්නවා ඒගොල්ලන්ගේ මහා ලොකු ජීවර යෝගිවරු හැබැයි මොන වහලා තියෙනවා අර අමුෂ්‍ය බලවේගයි අමුෂ්‍ය හැදිලා තියෙනවා අරකත් එක්ක ඒකයි අර ඇඩික්ෂන් එක ඒක ලේසි නේ ඒකකින් කුඩු ගහන්නේ ඒ වගේ පේන්නේ පේන්නේ තුනක් අර විදියටම බ්‍රේන් එකේ දොපමින් යන එකත් ඒක ඇගෙත් පේනවා කියන්නේ අදින ඉදිනවා වගේ අමුතු ස්වරූපයක් ඒ ලස්සන නැති වෙනවා කියන්නේ ෆ්‍රෙෂ් ගතිය නැහැ අර බීපු කෙනෙක් අපි බලන්නේ ඉතින් කිදිමිලා හැම තියෙන්නේ මගේ ලක්ෂණත් කියන්නේ තමයි කැත වෙනවා ප්‍රශ්න වෙන්නේ කැත වෙනවා දැන් රාගය කියන්නේ ඒ ඩොපමින් හොඳටම යන්නේ ඒක කෑමක් හොඳටම ඉන්නම I'm sorry I think so that so this is very I know like you know you get ugly you become ugly more you enjoy the food or anything like that and you know the computer So I tell that time I must tell you at the age of 14-15 I already had an idea that he will have this difficult time that only by religious activity he can overcome this period this I already had this knowledge from my certain gurus actually so then that time when he was there then suddenly I noticed something what I was going walking and something he was up to I then I came to my father And told him, you know, now they are so attached, you know, now his exams and all that. My father said, his exams are coming up and, you know, we can't, we must not disturb him. And he was helpless. Mm-hmm. I was thinking his character is more important than exams and all that. Just, you know, this for me was so important. So I didn't know how to, so what I did was, first, then I went to the shrine room, those days. I went to the shrine, locked myself, and started to meditate. And waited until the idea of brother went away from my mind. Understand? Until that idea, this is my brother and this, I feel worried about this, this feeling until it went away, because I knew this, because of my attachment and connection, this is going to muddle the whole thing. So I decided to slowly wait until, because while I am in mud, how can I help someone? So I knew already that you only by separating myself, so I waited. And then after that, I was thinking, what is my... Then I got an idea that how he was born to this family. Before that, did I worry about him? He's just a being coming to this family. Then after seeing, I'm getting the attachment to this body. It's not even him. How the consciousness start to work. And then how I make a relationship with it. This is my brother. For my father, he's son only. For me, brother, is it a real connection? Is it really there? Is he there really? No. You understand? Mm. This might be very helpful what I'm talking now. Mm-hmm. So when you get detached from that, you get this mental peace, my God. Yes. Then it is going to really solve the problem. You are now wisely liberating yourself from this entanglement of illusion, Maya. And when I was doing that slowly, after I did that only, then I knew what I should do. I should then advise him, tell the pros and cons. This is a duty as a brother, that's all. No emotion in it. So I went with my father, he knew he was caught also. So he was, I remember, with his pillow, he was sitting like this. So me and my father went into the room. And then I just told, my father was helpless, you know, he can't say anything, can't do anything because of that attachment. So he's, when you are in that state of mind, you can't help anyone. You are actually a harm to those people. Mm-hmm. So anyway, when I was with near my there, I just told him, you know, you should have told. I told him nicely because I had no anger, no tension. Just I was performing my duty. What I did was, I just told him, this is very personal, but can't help it. You know, I wish it will help your language. I don't know whether how much you would like me to tell. I told Mandy, you know, this is our duty. We should have told you before. Don't worry, it's not your fault. Like that, but made it sure that this is dangerous for him. I'm not telling not to do anything like that. I would not tell like that. It's not just to give him. So I am clear that I have done my duty. So just I did that, and after that I went to the island hermitage again. Quickly I went. Leave. I did my duty to the family. Leave. So always protect yourself and keep yourself. So now I see there's an energy. He's recovering. Now when I'm becoming more powerful, just automatically, not worrying about your family will be looked after. If you really go in the Dhamma, Buddha has the biggest insurance policy. So, and one is so reliable. If you practice the Dhamma, you must have that strong faith. It's not a statue or something. It's a live thing, the final live truth that can appear in this planet. But if you just do it and you don't have that much belief or not, but you find in first practical life, it will. So I didn't go like that with family, but I was with family, and that's how I did. Whenever there's a problem, another problem was when one of my cousins, you know, he passed away. His body was not to be found. This was in, this was very interesting. I think you'll have to put this, you know, out, you know, because I don't want to tell these things just for a group of people. I feel sorry, you know, because my heart is not for a few people. If it, I have idea that it will go to the others and then it will help them, I'll be happy. You understand?
Yeah.
Because I don't allow personal recordings. You know that no photograph personal. If it is done, it should be for everybody like that, something. Do you agree with that?
Yeah.
Then I will explain this.
Okay, we'll switch off.
Sorry? You can, if you put it on, you will have to put it out.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you can do that, no? I don't know how to. Because now, you know, I don't want to, you know, my heart is not, otherwise you can switch off, it's up to you. You can have a general talk, but I don't want you to keep alone and re-listen. You can listen to the YouTube one separately, but it doesn't matter, baby. You can do whatever you want, just type your own idea, right? So this cousin, this is what happened to him. He was in the Air Force. Actually, we were together more than my brother. He was just 1 year younger to me, and we had the same toys and everything. And so he joined the Air Force. He couldn't join the Air Lanka, so he joined the Air Force. And then he was, transporting 60 commandos to Palali or somewhere. And then this disappeared, I think. So what happened, some days back, I was at the island terminal. That time I was always there. I was like Upasaka. And when I went to, my teacher's, you know, Kuti, he just saw one day suddenly, my thoughts went to your cousin. He knows he's in the Air Force and all that. He just said, my thoughts went to your cousin. So I know he doesn't tell something. If he tells something, there's some meaning. He doesn't tell, other than the discourse, something, you know, he don't tell normally. So I just kept in mind. Next day, I get a telegram that quickly come to Colombo. So I told the other monk who gave me the gun, I think it must be about my cousin, because like this something Bhante told yesterday night. Then anyway, I went. When I went to see the whole, you know, home, I could see my grandma's place. All the relations get together. They are like, you know, and that time I had two sets of relations, my grandmother and my mother, one side. They all had a very deep belief in me. like they were, because they were pure, they were innocent people. Others were all full of, you know, they have put their head in a lot of things. Even the one now who is arranging, you know, they had some belief, but they don't know, you know, they feel sorry, this young boy. But the other two, they were my like pupils. But the others were like thinking, what is this meditation, what is his future and what is he going to do? But that occasion, they were all waiting now, how I will react. Because with all their knowledge and position, they can't face this reality. And they wonder now, how is this Chanaka at that time, he's going to face, and because they knew that I was with him, but by that time my mind was far away from all these relations and all that. Even, but he used to come always, you know, to my room or whatever, even in Colombo. So anyway, I came. Then when I came to the hall, I could see everybody looking. I just went straight to a room. I wanted to get away from the crowd. And I went and sat down on a chair, and my mother is the only one who came inside. And then I just sat down. And immediately I started to, now if I think he's my brother and my cousin and pastor, these are all, you know, if I think that way, the suffering will come. But immediately I remember I was practicing about the six Salayatana. Salayatana Vagga. In the island hermitage, I was watching this practice of seeing your sense organ, each sense organ, whether it's really your sense organ. And there's a practice. You watch and see. You see the rising and passing away of the eyes, the ears. So there's a rising and a passing away of the experience. So what is rising and passing away, can you call it you? Because you just didn't die immediately. So it's something not you. So then this news that came, you know, that my cousin is news, I don't want to have it, but it's coming. Something which I don't want is coming means what? This is in my control. This simple thing. Then I begin to see like another ear. This information, like another information, and this ear is not Nyala Chanaka that time. But this is the reality. But when I did like that, my mother saw that I was becoming, I didn't say what I'm doing, but she saw I was becoming very tranquil, peaceful. And she got a lot of faith. Because that time, those days I was not a monk, but then she used to worship. That time, because she just felt this is, you know, he's not feeling the suffering, what we are all going through as a family. So this is something, I mean, if you practice, this is not going to be an obstacle to your family life. This is going to liberate your family life, I think. If I was a husband, maybe. I mean, I was also planning like this, actually. I don't know, until the last moment. But there was this always. When I even have to wish for something, I have to always have this truth of, maybe I'll have a good partner and then I perfect this. I had this slight thought because of the defilement. Long when I was young, boy, you know, like, then when I used to come to a point where I know that if I wish something to happen now, at moment only one thought came. You know, the entire my life I must completely sacrifice. No any other. So this was depending on the intensity of my mind that time, these thoughts were coming. You get an answer.
Yeah.
You got more than an answer, right? Any other question? Actually, he told me that you have only been 4 years in Sri Lanka or something, right?
I speak Singhalese.
But I feel so shame, you know. All of you retain so much. Maybe you appreciate it more, and you know you value it more. Maybe, I don't know.
I think I always wanted to learn Singhalese, and I think I now know it's because I need to understand the Dharma.
No. I think you should have English to learn Dhamma, tell you honestly.
Okay.
Because the translations are very clear in English.
Okay.
Do you know there's a big problem in the Singhalese translation? Okay. So I hope you can read the Bhikkhu Bodhi Samyutta Nikaya,
yeah,
Word of the Buddha, like this. They're very simple, they're easy, then you don't have this struggle with the language.
To be honest, I read, Anurag was kind enough to read to me one of the sutras, Anuruddha Sutra. I don't want to get the names, it's simple anyway. And he read it to me in Singhala because I can read Singhala, but the Sutra Singhala was a bit too hard to read. And I could understand some of it, and I read the English version, and it just hit me so like clearly what this
was. Yeah, definitely. You know, the translation is very clear. And you can translate it back to your husband.
I think for him the Sinhala was really clear.
No, it's a little struggle is there, Sinhala. Man kiyanne Sinhala podi gadu podi dangalanda wenawa mokada are nathi gemburak dala thiyena e parna Sinhala dila thiyena me godak and meka sadlakana kiribath goda hamulo you has done something but still I feel some place I can't recommend a single person because some places is okay and some places he adds something, you know. And then the Nadi Mahal is there. Nadi Mahal translates that is also to avoid what the mistake they have done. So, but if you are really serious, you can go through it and then you get an idea. Because for the practice, just a few words somewhere here and there. So, sorry, can continue.
Mm-hmm. That I was thinking of the Bhikkhu Bodhi the last as well. That's the best English version to be looking at for the sutras as well.
The thing is, you know, it is good enough. For me, PTS translations we had those days in Island Hermitage was really helpful. So it is a better, more refined translation, I would say, with a more, I mean, Bhikkhu Bodhi, I think, is a very clever scholar monk. So don't think that you need actually, you don't need a, there's no really a, really a clear, you can't translate as such. Even if you know Pali is not the clearest. So this with the practice only becomes clear. You understand? If you don't practice, set by some things and really you do never, there's some things you should not try to understand, it should come automatically. So these things, how to know this, if only by purifying your life, then only suddenly you find that, but otherwise if you just think the words and it's like a communication that you just read and you become enlightened, no, they are like signposts, otherwise the signpost for your thinking. You can keep it beside your bedside, just one book, and just read a little bit, relax, like that it should go. And the word of the Buddha, you know, the word of the Buddha is very good. It's like a kind of a summary from the suttas. And there are a few places where they talk about the five elements. You can apply that. Beautiful. Then, you know, if someone is shouting or telling good or anything, or any bad experience, you can look at through that. You know, you will not feel it. You are in that vacuum idea of your being. That this is a concept. It is not the person. So these are practically you can do little simple things so that it gives you peace of mind and you are not affected by the environment and situation.
I think also one of them is recently I thought that thinking of the Buddha as a person was slightly flawed as well. Like if you just think of like the most perfect existence in nature sort of thing. Yeah, I just
want
to see what your views of that.
Like the Buddha as a person?
Yeah, but if you think of it as a person, that can help you get so much shut down and that faith as well. But also, if you think of as a state, the Buddha as a state, I think can bring it to this moment within you.
Yeah, Buddha can become alive in you. This is the Dhamma. Because Buddha's body and he of course had majesty and all that. There are times it helped me also in the jungle. Actually, I had a feeling like he was in the physical and he gave me mental strength. That is one type of practice. But tell you honestly, that's why the Buddha, when he was alive, because the Buddha's body and his personality has certain force, some type of force. But really, the Buddha is not the body. It was the Buddhahood took place in his mind. That is a kind of a thing. It is a, you know, like all this bodily formation is from the previous lives what he accumulated, which he brought, and we can see him. But that realization is something that is, you know, something which happens within him. And that is a state again. You know, it's a free from greed, hate, and delusion. This is how the shortest we can explain. It's a state free from greed. There are other states which are less of that. Like when you know, meditate and with wisdom, you come to the pinnacle of that mental state. So, that's why many times Buddha has told, Yo dhammam pasati, so mam pasati. So, what is dhamma? It is the conditionality. Apicca samuppada. When you see the conditionality, that's the beauty of the Buddha's teaching, the conditionality. Even the peacefulness, he sees the condition, it is also a condition experience. Now I know sometimes there are certain insight practitioners, these are very practically helpful for general overcoming stress and problems. Like for example, they see an empty space behind the sensual consciousness. Now, these are sensual objects, you have feelings, perceptions like this. So there's an empty space behind that empty space is a samadhi. Understand? So that samadhi also has subtle feelings, perceptions and so on. Buddha is talking about even that. So that comes as a realization where you turn away from every type of experience. So you're not in a feeling, you're in wisdom. So Buddha finally is not in any kind of feeling of peace even. It is your mind is filled with wisdom. Wisdom of the quality of this life, of this experience. So that's why one foreigner or a person of one gentleman once told me, Buddhism is phenomenology, isn't it, Bhante? Phenomenology. Very nice, very true. Phenomenology, study of phenomena. Even spiritual phenomena. Not only, you know, one might think only like physical study, no. It's also the consciousness, how it arises. It tells you any type of consciousness. Even if it is a peaceful one or a spiritual one, how it comes. It explains that so you're not, you know, like even the idea of God or any feelings of, you know, how the idea of I, self and creation. So these are now explained sometimes in the Dīghanikā, how the idea of that is also, well, the knowledge is good, but for practice, it's very nice. So whenever you are seeing how your contact came and how you got a feeling and how it is when the object of the feeling is no more, how the feeling is going away, you can study that. Now when you leave the memory of this, you can study how it was there, how it went away. Now we saw, I think, from that place yesterday, day before yesterday, no? Or yesterday?
Or this morning?
No, we went, we had the other program, the first program.
Vista.
Yeah, no? That is, yeah, there's a hall and.
Yeah.
So there you remember, you can remember something what happened and see how it is no more. It was a long, far away thing, but you can imagine how the perception is, you know, like. And now this is only for the moment, and you can think that how this the same thing happened to this, and so you connect to phenomena, what you know, the changing idea of, you know, that it's a convincing idea. So by exercising like that, term, you get anitya sanya happening. So you relate to, you know, when you read those suttas, you relate to your personal experience somewhere. If someone you feel worried about something. You must see, what is that something? That is, I'm conscious of it, of something. And what is in the conscious? The perception of something. Feelings, those are Buddha said feeling, perception. They are not you, they are not yourself. So you can just listen to him for a short while. When he says like that, you apply there, remember what you have been affected. And then when you look like that, you will notice something. And they will start to fall off. And then that falling off is a big revolution in your thinking, your wrong thinking. It's corrected by the enlightened masters, you know, investigation. It doesn't mean now, some are worried that if I practice like this, I'll become an arahant or something. Because they have other plans for me. No one will know what I'm doing really. You see, it's most important that you practice, remove illusion in your mind. Leave alone all this labeling. Many in Sri Lanka, this is a big problem, you know. Before the dish is made, the name is given. Name talk about, lot about the talk, but nothing is produced. I said, Perumpurunavna, Karunava ekamati, ekatana Perumpurunavna. Me nam dalno ne, budhu ena, mohakkar. Ekko me, ara, මේක සබහා ධර්මයෙන් එක වැඩේ වෙන්නයි ඕනේ කොහොමද අපි මේ වැඩේ කරන්නේ කියලා කියන්න ඕනේ ඒක අනිත්තර තාදශ we have to set an example to others we can't tell others to go you practice this I don't know so there is this I have this equation when you are practicing to remove ego and illusion then now there's a question some people will now in Sri Lanka this is a very problem and question like if they ask if you practice like that this is what arahants practice No, a bodhisattva will also practice, it's the real one. If he's in the sasana, he will then encourage people to remove this illusion. So this is very important to purify from illusion. We don't label what it is, but to overcome the idea of ego or idea of self. This is most important. And so this idea of self and to find lightness and this peacefulness will add to whatever you are, you know, that then you're already anchored properly. You don't worry, you don't fear. Oh, it's not හොඳලාට මම මේ ඔක්කොම පව කරන් ඇවිල්ලා ගොඩාක් I now enjoying the practice and but it's very surprising for me like a whole like some kind of thing is triggering in my trip this trip but I can feel this is like something the you know like devi devatan wasla connect වෙච්ච ගමනක් තමයි මේගොල්ලන්ගේ මොකක් හරි අද මම අපි බුදු මනුෂ්‍ය ලෝකේ ඉන්න අය දන ඒක මනස හයි වෙන්න ඕන they will you know think of you know like they would have more cleverness regarding the path so that you know you firmly establish the people in the practice give them the anchor to liberate quickly so that you know that you already accumulate so much merit by giving them the by not by saying you do it and then it will flow to them if you go to them like not eating sugar for 10 days මොන හරි කාටද දැනගන්න ඕනේ. ඔව් මේක තමයි මගේ ඇත්තටම ඉතින් my real journey I would say. But it's funny my teacher was someone who really knew already so many years back. And he was just like recommending me to help the people. A monk like him telling is a very that shows he had individual some knowledge really. This was
යම් කිසි අපි මොකක් හරි ප්‍රශ්නයක් එක ගැටි අපි ඉන්න තැන එන්වයරන්මන්ට් එකේ හරි හරි තැන ඉන්න තැනක අපි මේ ප්‍රශ්නයක් තියෙන මේ ප්‍රශ්නෙත් එක්ක ගැටි එතන ඉන්න එකද නැත්නම් නැත්තම් ඒක ඉතින් අයින් වෙලා යන එකද කොහොමද අපි මේ වගේ එකක්
ඒක හොඳ ප්‍රශ්නයක් මේක හොඳ ප්‍රායෝගික බලපාන එකක් නේ මෙහෙමයි ඒ දැන් ওই ප්‍රශ්නයක් වගේ එන්නේත් අපිට අපිට මන්ත්‍රිය සෝභා ධර්මයෙන් එන්නේ පාඩමක් හැටියට කියලා ඒක අපි දකින එකේ අපරාධය දාලයන් දන්නේ නරකයි. ප්‍රශ්නේ ඉන්නේ අපිට යම් නොපෙනෙන ආශිර්වාදයක් එකේ තියෙනවා. හැබැයි අපේ පංචශීල කැඩෙනවා නේද? කැඩෙනවා නම් කියලා ෂුවර් එකට දන්නවා නම් අලුත් කර්මයක් එහෙම කෙරෙනවා කියලා තේරෙනවා නම් අන්න එතකොට ඒක කායික වශයෙන් එහෙම වෙනසක් කරන්නේ හොඳයි ඒත් කරුණාවෙන් වෙනස් වෙන්න ඕනේ. ඒ කියන්නේ මනසේ ඒ ගතිය තියාගෙන තමයි මේ වෙනස කරන්න ඕනේ. එහෙම නැතුව ඒ තමන්ට හරියට මේ අර ප්‍රැක්ටිස් එක මේ කරගන්නම බැන චුට්ට පොඩි වෙලාවකට වෙනස් වෙලා එන්න බලාගෙන ඉන්න ඕනේ පොඩ්ඩක් අර මම හුස්ම ගන්න ශක්තියක් ලබා ගන්න. හැබැයි එතන ඒකේ එතන ඉඳගෙන තමයි වටින්නේ පුළුවන් නම් මේ තමන්ගේ අඩුපාඩුව හදා ගන්න බලන්න ඕනේ තමන් ඒක එතන ඉවසීම වෙන්න පුළුවන්. තව මේ ඉතින් හැදෙන්න තමයි මේ ස්වභාවික එතන තමයි වැටලා තියෙන්නේ. දැනද නැහැ. විතරක් කරාද ඒක?
ඔව් විතරක්.
බැදිනින් අනවගේ හොඳයි ප්‍රායෝගිකව මොකද ඊට මට උත්තර තියෙනවා
ඒක
තා කියලා කම ඉරේ වියන අර පැන්න පන්ති පැන්න
යබල්ල ඒක ජීවිතේ ගොඩනගා ගන්න
පුතේ දන්නවා එතකොට හැදිලා එනකොට ඊපස්සේ දැන් මටත් ප්‍රශ්න නැතුව තිබුණා නෙමෙයි හැබැයි මම මුලටම පැන්නේ නැහැ හොඳලාදම කට්ටි පැන්නේ නැහැ කලින්ටම ආවේ තාත්තත් එක්ක ෆස්ට් වන් ඒක පවර්ඩ් නේ නම් තාත්තනේ ඒක දේවනම් හොඳයි මේහා ගඩත් හරි වැඩි දැන් මම මේක නම් මේ he was telling like you know when you have sister like
getting up the environment
or if he has like a you know conflicting place you know where he has to stay or something how far you should allow that or how far you should go away So I was just telling that if it makes you to, because by nature gives you a situation for to get something, to change yourself. You know, it's like a lesson.
Yeah.
So if you, you must make a real decision if you are breaking the five precepts.
Mm.
That means you are making new karma in a strong way. Then with kindness, you should make a change or alternative. If not, it's good to stay there because that is where your gems are created.
Yeah.
So that is to develop inner qualities and patience and, You know, there's something that you're getting from there. So it's important to face the situation. It's important. And if you really can't, just for short while you can go and come like that. But still, best thing is, now I had to face it with my father. With my father, you know, he wanted me to finish at least the degree. And by that time, I don't want anything worldly. I'm a monk inside me. I had no desire to, you know, this was like hell for me to go to some worldly environment. Tell you honestly, coming here also, I have no interest in England. England or America, impossible. But there's something which intuitively, something which told me to go this. There was a different reason. So I'm happy one way. I'm not coming as a monk with desire for this place. No, impossible. And I want to be really desireless in terms of like an arahant, but that is not in my goal. But I don't come to it. I really enjoy to go to Himalayas or the forest in Sri Lanka. These are
maybe if you had not become a monk and you followed the path of your degree, you may have come to England or America anyway.
Yeah, I was to go to Oklahoma. I remember.
Well, there you go. So but, the destiny is there, but just in a different path.
Differently, but better to come like this. I'm not coming like a beggar now. I'm coming something to give. If I went for a degree, it would be like coming to get. I used to always rebel those days also in the university. Also, I used to say, why we come here? We are supposed to give something. Wisdom is there so much. And I used to argue with my friends and all that those days. And yeah, this is something. Yeah, definitely the destiny was there, I think. I was with LTT also, then that time I see that also my destiny. I would have been army sometime before, commander or something.
Mm.
So now I am having the karma to meet them, but in a different form. But I'm so happy.
Mm.
Yeah, I think so. It's funny how I had to be all the way, and my teacher saw this also. I told about this, in the past time, how he, that was very striking that time. So there's some karma, but nice to meet you all more as a more enlightened person than, really, then it will be the, that's why you go, you don't get distracted from what you're seeing, you pursue the path of liberation, you'll be meeting them anyway.
Yes.
But when you meet them, when you're an enlightened person, you'll be serving them greater. Now I meet, like Gihanta, one organizer, it's funny, we were in Ranwell, we used to, all days we used to play together. We were like same age. The cousin was 1 year younger to me. It was actually their family friend. Their family used to always meet us in when we were small those days, and they were close friends. And then I hear his name, that Gihanta is. Then actually I did know that he's. Then I got to know that he's the one. So anyway, now I say I'm so happy. I left all of them and then I went. Now I have a power to give them something. Now, if I got thought, I'm missing my friends and I stayed with them, I would just be with them. That was a worldly happiness, but I can't liberate them.
Mm.
You understand now? So it's like going to, even some people come out of their country to get money and give back to their family. The same way the spiritual wealth, you have to gain first enough, and if you do gain, it's going to help so many. But when you're going on a spiritual path, you don't feel like the people you knew already is only your family, because you have no connection to anyone and everybody becomes connected to you. Something like that happens.
Mm-hmm. Okay. We're going to leave now.
Okay, it's fine.
Yes. Okay. We had no particular question, didn't it? You just came to see me.
I came to see you. Sorry.
Okay, that's all right. Uh-huh.
Oh, thank you.
I don't accept.
To help with expenses or something.
No, I don't accept. No.
Okay, well, find it very, very interesting.
And I wish you good luck. Just stand there one minute. Thank you for your hair. Thank you for your great time. I wish you all good luck. And I wish you. You're a very strong person, a very special person.
Thank you.
And I hope that will.